All right, guys, this video is on projectile motion. This is part of lesson two that goes with graphing quadratics. All right, so we are going to answer three questions. I'm sorry, I did not take a screenshot of your notes page, but please make sure that you have that notes page. It starts with projectile motions. It has the same image and font that you just saw. If you cannot find it, please reach out to one of your teachers and let them know that you're not sure which page of notes that you're supposed to be using. But it says, a soccer ball is kicked from the ground with an initial upward velocity of 90 feet per second. The equation h equals negative t squared plus 90t gives the height, which is indicated by h, of the ball after t seconds. And what we're going to do is we're going to find the maximum height of the ball. So the first thing we're going to do is we're going to graph this equation. So we're going to come over here to Desmos. And we are going to input that equation. We're going to use x and y just in case the h and t's do not work. So negative 16, and I'm going to put my x squared right there, plus 90x. And you can either use your fingers for your touch screen, or you can use the plus or minus that you see over to the side. You also have the option of changing your window using that little tool at the top right above the plus sign, but I think using your fingers works just fine to try to find the maximum. And so, just like what we've always done with Desmos, in order to find your vertex, if you get close enough, it should give you the gray dot. There it is. All right, so that is the maximum height would be your y value. Remember, in an ordered pair, you have x comma y. So our height, the maximum height, is 126.563. And this is given to you in feet. So let's take a little quick screenshot there. We're going to copy and paste that back over here. So there is my maximum height. So just to make sure I answer the question. Put feet on it because that is our units. And remember, anytime you're doing real world applications, you always have to include your units. All right. So part B says, how many seconds will it take for the ball to reach the ground? And I actually pasted that question over here. So now you come back over here to your graph, and when it hits the ground, that is looking for a root and or a zero. Because remember, roots and zeros indicate x-intercepts. So we're looking for where it crosses the x-axis. And remember, this graph crosses twice. Because if you slide it over ever so slightly, we have an x-intercept right here because it started on the ground. So the soccer ball started on the ground and comes back to the ground. So there's one of our x-intercepts, and here's the other one. I'm going to squeeze that in just a little bit so that you can clearly see those two at the same time. And again, I'm going to grab a screenshot and paste it into my notes. All right, so how many seconds will it take for the ball to hit the ground? We have it right here, 5.625, and our units here is seconds. All right, so now we go over to number two, and number two says, an apple is launched directly upward from 64 feet per second from a platform 80 feet high. The equation for this apple's height, h, at time t seconds after launch is h equals negative 16t squared plus 64t plus 84. We're going to find those same two things that we found in the last equation. We're going to find the maximum height of the apple, and we're also going to find the number of seconds it takes for the apple to reach the ground. So now, let's change this equation up ever so slightly. So negative 16t squared plus 64. Make that an x plus, plus 80. All right, so this one does not have that same intercept at the vertex because it does not start at the ground. It starts at 80. So that 80 is what we call the y-intercept. Right here at 0, 80 is your y-intercept. We're looking for the maximum height. So our maximum happens up here. Please make sure that you're not trying to find these things algebraically unless you're required to find them algebraically. And if you were trying to find it algebraically, you would find your axis of symmetry and then plug that x value into your equation to get your y. But unless you're required to find it algebraically, please find those things graphically. All right, so we grab that little screenshot, copy it, and we're going to paste it in here. So there's our maximum height, and then we're going to do the same thing for when it hits the ground, which we probably should have done when we started it because we were already on the x-axis when we started. All right, so we're just going to click, find our value, and that one is 5. All right, so it takes 5 seconds for the apple to hit the ground. If you were to try to find that algebraically, you can do that by using the quadratic formula. I wouldn't recommend any of the other methods, especially not trying to complete the square or anything like that. In science class, the students were asked to create a container to hold an egg. They would then drop the container from a window 25 feet above the ground. Find the container's height, h, after t seconds. And then we're also going to find when it hits the ground. So we're going to put that equation in. Negative t squared plus 25. Alright, so here's our graph. Our maximum happens at 25 because if you think about it, you're dropping something from the window. So that would be the highest it goes because you're not curving the path, you're just dropping it directly down. So the maximum height is 25 and it takes 1.25 seconds for that egg. Yeah, for the egg to hit the ground. So that one screenshot here is going to take care of both of those answers to the questions. Uh-oh, I didn't copy. To both of the questions for number 3. But just in case you need me to indicate which answer goes with which question, A is 25 feet, and how many seconds? 1.25 seconds is the answer for part B. I'm also going to do number 7, so it's on the page right after this one, because we're trying to determine if it would ever reach a height of 14 feet, and I want to show you how to do a question like that. So again, we're going to jump over here to Desmos. We're going to put in the equation for number 7 because it says Eva is jumping on a trampoline. Her height h at time t can be modeled by the equation negative 16t squared plus 20t, which again we're going to put as an x in Desmos, plus 20x plus 6. And we're trying to see if it ever reaches a height of 14 feet. So you can do that one of two ways. You can put in to Desmos. Let me see if I can slide the viewing window for Desmos over just slightly so you can see where I'm inputting the equation, that y equals 14. So that way you can see clearly that that blue line and the red line do not touch. Or you can just look at the red one and see that the maximum height is 12.25 feet. So because the maximum height is 12.5, it never reaches a value of 14. So the answer to that question is no. That is not a, it is not a possibility for this particular scenario. All right, so squeeze that in there, and then just to answer the question, we're going to put in no max height is 12.25 feet. It cannot reach. All right, so now let's squeeze that back into that window so y'all can see the whole thing. And then I'm also going to take that out of a cursive font so that you can clearly write that into your notes without having to fight the cursive. There you go. Take a minute, pause the video if you need to go back, rewatch any parts of it. But let us know if you have any questions.